After venting their creative steam into solo projects, the members of Fleetwood Mac turned their attention to the long-awaited group album.
The way we approached making Mirage was an attempt, you know, certainly to start with, to unify the five members. We have made this album exactly in the same way we would approach, and it's not musically the same, I hope, to goodness it's not, but in terms of regimenting what we should do or not do, there's no other influence other than internally. We just choose the songs we want to do. We prune them out in terms of, there's usually about three or four songs that don't make it onto an album and make it permanently shoved in a corner somewhere. And that's the way we approach it. We try to balance it out between the three songwriters, which is sort of a problem, but a good problem. But you have to be very aware of making sure that there's not too much of, you know, Lindsey or too much of Chris or Stevie come to that. So that's really the only thing that we have to worry about, is presenting the whole band as a band and make sure it's all in balance, you know.
Mirage was done certainly, it was a much more collective effort than Tusk was. I don't really think that Tusk was quite as fragmented as some people thought.
Some parts of Tusk were fragmented in terms of people, oh, you're in and out the studio, were you there, and you all hate each other and all that business, had actually nothing to do with it at all. Purely and simply, Lindsey did a lot of work on his own on Tusk, versus this time, the whole thing has been approached very much as a band unit, certainly all the rhythm section and so forth. So to that extent, it's somewhat being approached differently.
The Mirage album, John is playing all the basses, Mick's playing all the drums, Christine is playing a good deal of the keyboards, and there's a lot more vocalizing collectively than there was on the Tusk album. And at the same time, I would say that it's certainly not what you could call a reactionary album. There was a tendency after Tusk came out to certain people in the band and outside of the band to say, well, we've got to return to a rumors format because that was a much more viable way of approaching it in terms of sales. And this is somewhat of, from my point of view, some of the best of both worlds. It's got an experimental edge to it, and at the same time, it's, I think, something that's going to be a lot more accessible to a broader number of people.
While the group's approach to recording Mirage may have been different, the public's response has been overwhelming, and once again, the band has a hit record on its hands. One of the most popular tracks on the album is Hold Me, a song co-written by Christine McVie.
I wrote Hold Me with Robbie Patton, actually. I can't even remember when, but it was just one of those songs that, you know, was just coughed up about midnight one night. It took us about an hour to just kind of plod through it, and it just seemed to have a nice kind of lollop to it. And originally I was singing it with Robbie, and the idea was, when I did it on this album, I was going to sing it along with myself, you know. It turned out that Lindsey sung the other part, and it's a pretty lightweight song. It doesn't have any heavy meaning in particular. The words are a little strange in places, but they just sound good in the track, so it's one of my triter songs. I mean, meaning-wise, I just like the melody and the feeling on it. You know, we only have a few songs each. I mean, I had four, Lindsey has four, I think Stevie has three. And it just seemed, you know, when a, you know, painting's a little bit smaller, you can do a bit more detail on it, you know, and it's just easy to, but it was just fun for us. I think we just enjoyed each other's company a lot more on this particular album.
Mirage also features a Stevie Nicks composition called Gypsy, a song that's as beautiful to see as it is to hear.
Gypsy is about going back to the gypsy that I was prior to Fleetwood Mac.
I see.
To putting my bed back on the floor and moving all my speakers and everything, all my toys, into a little room and kind of hibernating in there for a couple of months, a couple years ago.
There really aren't that many songs that each of us write that the others don't like in some form or other, which, you know, in the end, when you, if it's, say, Stevie's written a song, it ends up having a, like I say, in this particular case, we all work so much on each other's songs that it has a little flavor of every other band member anyway, you know?
It's been a reconciliation of opposites. One of the psychologists, probably Jung, I think, said that a reconciliation of opposites constitutes growth. So that was one extreme that was reached for, and then turning a corner and coming back and reconciling the best of what was learned from that with the best of what came before. So in that way, we feel very, very strong about this album, that it really represents a lot of different growth patterns, and it's a culmination of a lot of different things.
Fleetwood Mac is not the be-all and end-all of our lives. I think for many years I've certainly felt that nothing else existed other than Fleetwood Mac, and I don't think that's necessarily very healthy. I think it's been very healthy to find that there are other things you can do and still function within a working unit as we are now. So I think it's been an extremely healthy thing for all of us to get out of the framework of Fleetwood Mac and to be able to come back. You know, I think you can be more objective about both ends, your own personal careers or whatever you like to call it, plus your involvement with other people with Fleetwood Mac. I think it's helped a lot.
In the midst of all the rumors that have been flying around about the group, that we are coming out with an album that's a very strong statement. I think it means something that we're going out on the road and playing dates. That's as far as I can really predict, but we're still here, you know. So
this album, which has been very much a group project, we've all really had a lot of fun.
I like the music better.
It was a total pleasure, musically mainly, and outside of that, it was a whole lot of fun. Hard work, but a lot of fun.